So, good afternoon, it's Daryl Freeman. I'm in the cockpit with a good friend, Charles Sewing, who is a Nashville entrepreneur, been in business for a number of years now. And I just wanted to have a conversation with Charles about why he became an entrepreneur. As you all know, we live in the greatest free enterprise system in the world. And being an entrepreneur gives you a chance to take advantage of it. So Charles, why did you become, well, first introduce yourself and tell us why you became an entrepreneur.
All right. Well, as Daryl said, my name is Charles Sewing. I own Sewing Insurance Agency. We're based out of Nashville. Believe it or not, I've been in business for 20 years.
Wow.
This year. This is in January. We began the 20th year of Sewing Insurance Agency. And it's been a good ride. Obviously, it's had some ups and downs. I was young when I became an entrepreneur. Didn't really understand all the risk involved, but had a
That's
dream.
Good.
Yeah, it is. It turned out to be good.
Yeah.
Because had you known that there could be so many ups and downs, you know, you can make a different decision.
Yes.
But I was fortunate enough to get to have some great mentors and people that have been in my life since the early days. And it's really helped shape what we've been able to accomplish so far.
So, I mean, there's a lot of people who will start businesses, and some will be successful and some won't. You've been very successful at it. You've been in business for 20 years. You've been using this business to create wealth and to feed your family, which is major, and also to create jobs and opportunities for others. So what do you think those nuggets are that have made you successful?
You know, the beginning part of it is the why. You know, what are you in it for? Obviously, we all want to drive revenue. We want to be successful financially. But I think you have to have a higher purpose. And when you can do something that's actually bringing value to others and helping build others, helping others build their dreams and bring their dreams come true, then I think that's one of the keys to success.
So when you ran across, as an entrepreneur myself, I've run across a number of obstacles. When you ran across obstacles or you ran into obstacles, what did you do?
You stay with it. You just keep going. When you want to quit, you just don't. You try to find others who can be supportive, other people who may have some challenges that can help you along the way.
Gotcha. So never quit. Never give up.
Don't quit. Don't quit.
Gotcha. So
someone said just recently that there's a deal out there for everybody. You just got to stay in business long enough.
You
got
to stay in business long enough to get it. So, and I firmly believe that. I was in business for myself for 20-something years. Had I quit early, there were some deals that I did that I would never got a chance to do had I quit.
Yeah.
What are some of the other obstacles that you've run across that you've had to overcome?
You know, there's business can be cyclical.
Yes.
You know, you can have upsides and downsides and you know, finding the right balance of people and staffing that believe in your dream nearly as much as you do can help sustain surrounding yourself with the right people, both inside your business and those that you surround yourself with in the community, that can be very impactful.
Gotcha. So if you had a chance to do it again, obviously you would do it again.
Absolutely.
And if I had a chance, I would do it again as well. However, I think we could have both been successful in corporate America, but I think we chose a different path. And,
you know, you get out of it what you put into it. Early on in my first couple years with Nationwide Insurance, I saw what was happening to those on the corporate side of things. Back then in the early 90s, you had upsizing and downsizing and right-sizing, and people that brought value to the company often still found themselves being either relocating from city to city, and if they had families, that was disruptive, or they might put you in charge of a department and 2 years later decide that department's no longer necessary and you find yourself, you know, starting over again.
Yeah.
So as an entrepreneur, you don't have that struggle.
Yeah, so I guess you could say as an entrepreneur, you get a chance to control your own destiny.
You do control your own destiny. For better or for worse.
Yes,
You control your own destiny.
Well, I appreciate you traveling with me today. With my mentor and your mentor, Sam Howard.
Yes, yes.
It's been an awesome day.
I got two mentors in the
Well, you're very, very nice to say that. We've all had some success, and probably most of it has nothing to do with what we've done, but the assistance we've received from others. So, signing off from here with Charles Sewing, who's a very successful entrepreneur in Nashville. run up against the obstacle. Don't quit.
Okay,
keep
well,
going. Surround yourself
three,
with good
zero,
people.
We'll
stay in business long enough
three, zero,
to get the deal. Signing off with Mr. Soing.
Michael 7,
thank you, sir.
Contact.
Thank you.
Center.